transition to digital television is just moments away from now. We've been telling you about it for more than a year, and we do hope that you're ready. Let's check back in with Three on Your Side's Jim Donovan, who's in our Great Hall. Jim?
Good afternoon, Pat. What will happen in about the next 6 minutes, we will be making that switch from analog to digital. If you are not ready, your set's not ready, you will see snow or static, and then you will see a video that basically describes in English and in Spanish what steps you need to do in order to get your programming back. Now, if you have a converter box and it's all hooked up, you need to rescan after 12:30. That means scan through the channels, because some channels will be switching on the spectrum. So look up your directions, rescan, and then you should be ready to go. In the meantime, we're here until 7 o'clock tonight. The number on the screen, 1-877-KYW-3-ASK. We're ready to go in just 6 minutes. Pat, back to you.
All right, Jim, thanks very much. We hope no one sees any snow out there. Well, one more time, the switch to digital TV taking place at 12:30 this afternoon here at CBS3 and on our CW Philly station. Alex is...
You're watching KYW-TV. The switch to digital is happening now.
With causing another man's death by giving him a deadly mix of drugs. Center police say this man, Kevin, is in homicide in the death of 24-year-old Ethan Redman.
Kevin has Redman take all these pills, smoke PCP, and then after all that, Kevin Askew supplied him with some cough syrup, some prescription cough syrup, actually quite a bit.
Askew is in the Shelby County Jail. Well, this story has been mentioned. A homeless man stunned police. More than $2,300 in cash in his tennis shoe. Was arrested after people complained about him coming up to vehicles stopped at Burt Coons in the Inner Loop. He spent 5 days in the city jail and paid $2,000 in fines and fees. The Shreveport City Council passed its anti-panhandling law back in 2004. Former city councilman Jeff Hogan was behind that push. It was against the law. Hogan says it's illegal in the city.
It doesn't take. Yeah, that can't do.
Doesn't have a law against panhandling, but it does enforce a state law that prohibits panhandling on interstates like I-20. James Burton is hoping this year's guitar festival makes it into the record books. Burton hopes the guitars played in unison for 5 minutes. They plan to perform two tribute songs to Elvis Presley during that attempt.
One of the greatest artists that ever lived, and even today is very huge in the world. It's just a great thing to pay tribute to him. I worked with him 9 years, and a wonderful man, and just a great talent.
Kicks off on August 2nd. This is a big score for the Bossier Shreveport Mudbugs. It looks like the team will soon have a new owner. Current owner John Madden has approved a letter of intent from a group of investors who want to buy the team. The team's attorney will now write up an asset agreement. The buyers will... The transfer of ownership should take 2 weeks. We've also been told that one of the first orders of business would be to get Scott Musket back in the fold as the head coach. Now, if every T is crossed and every...
I'm Mike DeSirio from the National Association of Broadcasters. From now on, this television station is no longer running regular programming in an analog format, and is broadcasting exclusively in digital. The switch only affects viewers who watch TV using antennas. If you're seeing this message, this television set has not yet been upgraded to digital, or your equipment is not working properly. If you subscribe to a pay TV service like cable or satellite, you should call your provider immediately. This short program is designed to help viewers upgrade to digital. We'll help you set up a converter box, talk about antennas, and answer many questions about digital television. We'll also help you scan for channels, a very important step that everyone with a new TV set or converter box should do today. Please keep watching this entire program. At the end, we'll provide a phone number for more information. To continue watching free television with an antenna, you have to upgrade in one of three ways. First, you can purchase a new set with a digital ATSC tuner. Most TV sets sold in the last 2 to 3 years have digital tuners, which can pick up all the digital programming out there. Visit dtvtransition.org and click Is My TV a DTV to see if you have a digital TV. You know your set has a digital tuner if the channel numbers come up on the screen with a dash or a period. For example, channel 4 would come up as channel 4.1 or 4-1. If you see periods or dashes, your TV set is digital, so you should try rescanning or reprogramming for channels. More on rescanning in a minute. Second, you can purchase a converter box, which makes digital programming viewable on older TVs. Converter boxes cost between $40 and $70.
We have reached that pivotal moment in television history. After talking about it for more than 2 years, the moment has finally arrived for WREL to make the DTV transition.
WREL's Monica La Liberty and the president and CEO of Capital Broadcasting, Jim Goodman, join us again from the transmitter in Auburn. Time to flip that switch, Monica.
Oh my gosh, we are ready. You know, though, this really should be a non-event for most television viewers. I mean, 42% of the country has actually already made the switch. Remember, we were originally supposed to do it in February, and then it was delayed to give folks more time. But yes, today is the day now, officially, for everybody. It's the end. I am here. There is the button. I've got Jim Goodman here, ready to make that switch. But I want to quickly remind everybody, when we do that, we are going to go off the air for about 5 minutes. And that is the time, except if you're a Time Warner Cable customer, you won't notice anything, or at least that's what we're hoping. But we're going to go off the air for about 5 minutes, and that is the time that if you get us over the air with an antenna, you have a converter box, that you go ahead and unplug your television, unplug your converter box so that you can rescan for channels. But now it's time. Let's do it. Are you ready?
Thank you. We'll have a talk. I'm ready.
Don't hit the wrong button.
I want that. So here's what we're doing.
Okay.
If you're watching WRAL-TV Channel 5 analog over the air right now with an antenna, we're turning her off. She's going to be gone. So then you're going to start watching WRAL on digital, right? So we're going to turn off the analog.
Let me step out of the way.
I'm going to do one and you do one. I'm going to turn off the plate voltage and you're going to turn off the film. I'm going to turn off plate.